he was a modern man. He was a clean-shaven American. But the fact he was a big Talmid Chochem, a very strong Gerer Chosid, and altogether very sharp, liked to smoke cigars. It was very... When I came here and I was in the beginning in the West Side, when I came to the city, to New York, and he lived in the West Side, so I looked forward to meet with him. He was a very interesting talker, schmoozer. And while we talked about something, he mentioned that he knew the Lubavitch Rebbe, and he told me he knew him from Berlin. So I said, how do you know him? So he started to tell me that the Rebbe was a student in the university, and he was very impressed by the Rebbe. And he said, ah, in every respect, I don't have to tell what the Lubavitch Rebbe was. He was very, very impressed. For me, it meant a lot because he generally was a critic. I very rarely heard from Mitchemeyer praise about someone, rather the negative sides. And here, it was full of praise. He told me, by the way, the Rebbe never changed. He always wore a hat or something, or beret or something, which in Germany was unusual. Because here you don't understand that, but in Berlin, in Germany, you couldn't enter a bank not taking off your hat. Or go to a drugstore, you had to take off your hat. They would tell you that you have to do it. And he had a beard, uncut, untouched. But that was not the godless, I have to tell all the rabbis, that he did have a beard. He saw more in the rabbis than these trivialities. They lived more or less in the same neighborhood. It was a neighborhood called Grenadierstraße. That was the main street of the Stiebler. So in Grenadierstraße were probably 15 Stiebler. And I know where the Rebbe davened. Rebbe davened, they told me, in Domberger Stiebel, which was not right there, but also not very far. When the Welder Rebbe came to Berlin to see an eye doctor, so the Lubavitch Rebbe told the Chmeyer, you know what I hear? The Welder Rebbe is here. I would like to see him. And so they went, they knew where he was staying. They went, the two of them went up. And the Rebbe was standing with closed eyes because he couldn't, he had a problem with his vision. And people were in line giving shulim one after another. And he had on his hand a towel. And that's how he gave shulim, with it through the towel. One of Chmaya gave shulim, then the Rebbe gave shulim, and the Rebbe gave shulim. He looked up, maybe opened his eyes, and he took off the towel, and he gave him shulim with the hand. Everybody there was astonished, made an exception here. So they started to ask the Chmaya, who is this? Who is he? So he said he's the Edim of the Lubavitcher Rebbe.